The rock group The Band left an indelible mark on music in the 20th century. The drummer from the band, Levon Helm, was a formidable force well into the 21st. One of his legacies is a performance space where the music made there seems to have his spirit infused in it. NewsHour Weekend's Tom Casciato has more.
The Levon Helm Studios in Woodstock, New York are named, of course, for the legendary late drummer for the band, Levon Helm. He once held his famed rambles here, musical gatherings that first helped pay the rent. They soon became notable events. We spoke about his legacy to another legend who lives in Woodstock and has played in the barn many times, singer-songwriter and leader of the Love and Spoonful, John Sebastian.
Levon built this barn as a place for musicians. It really wasn't primarily an audience-related thing in the beginning. It is a wonderful place to play. It has lots of places for sound to move around and escape and not get trapped, and it sounds really good.
What kind of ghosts are in this place?
You know, so many great players played in this space up above. People like Hubert Sumlin and Johnny Johnson, and that's even before you get to the people my age who are also crazy talented.
People like Dr. John, Mavis Staples, Elvis Costello, Emmylou Harris, and of course, Levon Helm himself.
People maybe don't all realize the depth of Levon's musicianship. He was so low-key about all of that, and oh, I don't know, we're just gonna play the backbeat. I just gotta be rubbing a shuffle here, and all of a sudden this wonderful groove would emerge, and everybody always had the same reaction. This is one of the most fun things I've ever done, you know? It was like that for a lot of folks.
The studios are a sought-after concert venue now, owned and operated by Levon's daughter, musician Amy Helm. As for the legacy of Levon Helm himself?
Levon left a huge mark for all of us. And it is epitomized by these rooms. We wish he was still here.